Hi, Aunt Lindy. Hello, everyone. This is Deborah from Old Mom's Old Stuff. I've got a lot of stuff, as I always do, for you. I went to Joplin, Missouri today and went to the flea market and to an antique store, and I can't wait to show you the stuff that I got there. The things that I'm going to show you today are mostly from estate sales, and I've taken pictures of these and I've removed the price tags, so I'll try to remember what I paid for them, but I probably won't be able to. So I kind of divided my things up, and these are going to be the bigger items. And then next time I'll show you, I've got a lot of glass that I want to show you. So we'll start out. I have several, what are they? They're called, there's a specific name for them. I told myself I'd remember them, remember what it is. The brand name, the most famous brand name, the best-selling brand name, the best-rated brand name is Thermos. But they're insulated containers, insulated food or beverage containers. That's the generic name for them. And in my mind, I think if you're going to be serving something hot or cold, this time of year, probably something cold, I think, why not make it special? Something that's going to keep it cold, but will look nice and you will be pleased and proud to display. So, we'll start with the more fancy of the things. And we're going to start with this one right here. Look at this. Now, this brand is... This is not a Thermos brand. It's made in Taiwan. I paid $3 for this one. But this one is fancy. Look at that. Of course, the lid comes off. And they look like the ones, like the Thermos ones. It's got the glass inside. Now, I wonder, when you shake these, and if you hear a, like, I don't hear any rattling in this particular one, does that mean it doesn't work anymore? I don't know. I don't even know why I think that, but I've heard that. So $3 for this. It is fancy, has a few scuffs on it if you look really close. Then the other one that I thought was really cool looking, it reminds me of the really mid-century. This one also, this is not a Thermos brand. This is Ancona Design International Housewares Inc. And 1996 is this one. But look at this. Look at the design. The angle at the top, the black and the white. Same thing. Now, when I cleaned these, I took them all apart. Took the bottoms out, took the glass part out, cleaned it all. Now, this thing makes a statement, I feel like, for what it is. Again, I don't remember how much I paid for that. Probably about the same price. Probably about $3. This one, dig this color. I just think this is a lot of times you see this with that kind of maroon color, kind of more like this color. But I saw this, it's very different. This one, ThermoServe, made in the USA. The typical. This one doesn't come all apart like the other ones do. But it is sharp looking and unique, different. I really like this color green. So we have that one. Yikes. Now this one is a good old fashioned, it says I paid $7.50 for this, thermos. No rattling in this one. And it's got all the parts. Look at that. That color. This one is, I'm trying to look and see, it's a quart size stainless steel vacuum bottle. I don't remember what year this is. And again, it has a few minor scuffs on it that if you look real close, you can see. This is nice and big. This is for a man to take his lunch in. Or a woman, hard worker. So we have this one. Okay, now, this one, this is I'm trying to make, see if this is, I can't read the, but this, yeah, this is thermos. 1968 King Sealy thermos. Check that out. Now these sell for around $20. I have a Barbie one I'm keeping. Now this one has a little rattle inside. What does that mean? But look at that. I think this must have been some kind of show then. Secret Agent or maybe a comic. But again, it's got all its parts. Now, it was probably meant for a youngster to take to school for their lunch, but I bet you a youngster doesn't use this now. I bet some grown-up wants this one. Okay, so those are the beverage and food warmer things. So the next big thing, we'll start from the back. I got this from the thrift store, and I believe I paid $7 for this. I had seen it and watched it and waited till it went for half price, and then I got this. This is made in Japan. Am I putting this right for you? Can you see that? But I just, it's a vase or some other long things you could put in it for storage. But check that blue and the white with the floral and the streaks, the way they painted it horizontally like that. Really like that. It's beautiful. Okay, so the next thing, oh, this is a big one. This is the Haeger. Look at this. Now this is one of my favorite colors, and it looks like it's antiqued. This urn or vase, it's got some, I don't know if you can see, it's got some discolored areas inside, but I mean, this is beautiful. And the Haeger stamp on the bottom. This to me is just elegant. You don't even need to put any flowers in it or branches or whatever you might put in it. It says something by itself. So we have that. Now this is an old kaleidoscope. Now, when I was little, the little toy kaleidoscopes, and you show up in the light and show all different kind of colors and stuff like that, this doesn't show so as many different colors. It depends on what you're aiming it at, but it is quite interesting, and I think it's just a handsome piece just to set, just a display piece. Look at the screws. flat head, the bottom. It's just in great shape. Again, I don't remember what I paid for this. I got this from an estate sale. So we have that. Now this, I've seen this before, but it would be so much damage. Look at that. Look the contrast of these colors. And it is, now, to look at it, you would not know that it has any flaws. And when I bought it, it didn't appear to have any flaws. But when I got home, it had a couple of flaws. These little pieces are quite delicate, and a couple had broken off. And you probably won't be able to tell where I repaired them. But then as I looked closer, I saw that some others had been repaired. You cannot tell unless you really look closely and remember which ones were repaired. I put this on Facebook Marketplace because I'm confident that in the mail, these little things would get broken. I just don't know if it could be packed, if I could pack it well enough that it wouldn't be broken, just because they're so delicate. But I mean, that is snazzy. That, I think, you know, this is something that I would like to take to work and put on my desk or on the shelves that I have in my office. Okay. So this is a signed Japanese mixed metal vase. And I just felt that I didn't realize it has a slight dent here. Now, what, can you see the signature? See it right there? I got this at an estate sale, and I do not remember how much I paid for this. Because I've taken pictures of these, and I had the prices with the pictures and my listings in the notebook that I keep until I post it. But it's a bird, you know, on a branch in a tree. And it does say, I don't know if you're going to be able to see, that it says Japan on the bottom. But it came with the promenades. Oh, shoot. So, this is how I know about it. This came with it. And this little note. It says, these are collector's items bought by Lonnie Hamner while in the Navy in 1953. Shipped from Japan, Saigon, Okinawa. Paid for by Rossi Hamner, given to Ira Faye Vanderpool. And the person signed it, she wrote this in 2001. So this will come with it. So, this is at least 1953 when it was made. The note, to me, is what made this piece. I've seen them priced for around $40 online. This other one is also Asian, but it's Korean. Look at this lacquer box. I saw one of these at the antique store that I went to today, but it didn't have the lid. I don't know if anyone would know it had the lid. I know that it had the lid because I have this. And so look at these angelfish. I think that's what they are. This is in very good condition. It has couple of marks on the lid. And then these fish on this side, I believe these are supposed to be koi fish on that side. And then the lid is painted and the base has this kind of mottled look to it. It's from Korea. I'm sorry, Vietnam. Made in Vietnam. I think I could get between $30 and $40 for that one. Okay, so this is a McCoy piece. Again, I had seen this at an antique store and I liked it because it's red. It's got the butterfly on it and the flower motif there. And it says McCoy. Can you see that? White inside. It had a couple of little chips. Again, you have to search to find them. So, half price, I got this. It's not uncommon, but still, I think when somebody sees it in my store, they'll grab it. Now these two, I got these at an estate sale. Mother of pearl glazed swans with the, it's almost like a, it's not really, it's more like a silver highlights at the base and on the wings. But look at that. These are delicate. These are Norcrest, Japan. Now, when I ship these, I will be taking some pool noodles wrapped around those necks. And so far, I've got a pretty good record with my shipping. I might put these on Facebook Marketplace. Oh, because those necks are really delicate. They're pretty lightweight, but so elegant. I got these on the last day, either half price or 75% off of the estate sale. And I don't remember how much I paid for them. Okay, so this other big thing that I got, look at this. Now this is Los Angeles Pottycrix, USA. Can you see that? Vintage, I don't know. You think this is, I think that's 70s. The back. I just, these things that I'm starting to be a little bit more discerning and pick out, they're each a piece of art. And again, you don't have to put your snacks in here. You can, but just setting out, it's beautiful. So it's dual purpose. It's a piece of art and it's a snack holder. Okay, oops, Tiki. this is Honolulu, Ali Woods. This is wood. It's got a little bit of dried out area on his toes. But this is tiki all the way. I think someone will snatch this up. These next two things I just thought were so, I feel like this one. So it's really the wood, the frame and the back are on one piece. It's got a hanger there. And then it looks like I think it's all one piece. This is not attached. I think it they carved this out of this whole piece of wood somehow. Now, I'm no wood expert, but that's what it looks like to me. This just looks like a very special piece to me because it's handmade, obviously. And I believe it's vintage. Very nice piece. Now this one. This. Oh, I wish you could see it all. Because it might not be quite 2 feet, but it's close to it. So here we are back here. But look at this. And he's got, I don't know if those eyes are glass or plastic. But it's even got a knot hole in the tree that he's in. And this hangs up, it's got a hanger in the back. So you can hang it on the wall. It's lightweight, so it'll hang nicely. It's got this marking on the back. I don't remember how much I paid for this either. This, I believe, I got at the thrift store. These last two wooden pieces I got from the thrift stores. Well, all three of them, the tiki, and these two. Okay, so I'm having to reach way down here because I have the cart that I told you that I got. It's in front of me now. I have everything on it, but some of the things are in front. So this I got at an estate sale. I saw it the first day. I didn't want to pay the $4, so I went on half price day. Again, very much definitely Asian themed tin. It doesn't say where it was made, but the lid is hinged. Ooh. Excellent condition. If it's got some scratches on it, you'd have to get pretty close. I haven't seen any scratches on it. Oh gosh. Obviously, it's just for decor, but of course, a wise person would use it for some storage. So, a hinged lid. There's the top of the lid. Very good condition. For $2, we have that. And then, oh shoot, forgive me, I'm right here guys. Ooh. Sorry if I rattled you around. Okay, I paid $3 for this. Look, this is, well, it's an M&M candy dish or soap dish. You know, okay, so I make soap, right? And the little leftovers, when I clean out the crock pot or whatever container or vessel that I make the soap in, depending if it's hot or cold processed, yada, yada, whatever's left, all of that is precious. I scrape all that together and I make soap balls. And I have about 3 different containers in this house full of different size soap balls. And I think that a bunch of soap balls would look really cute in here. Now, you also could use it to put M&Ms in. Look at that. Is that fun? I mean, that is just fun. Okay, well, we're at less than 30 minutes this time. That's all I'm going to show you for now. Thank you for watching, and I would love it if you would subscribe, tell all your friends, subscribe. And either thumbs up or thumbs down. And if you have any suggestions, comments, questions, please do put it in the comments. I think linked in my, I'm pretty sure linked in my videos is my eBay store, which is Deb's Clothes Are Large, my Poshmark, and my Mercari, where you can buy things. Not these things, I'm not sure when I'll get them listed, but a whole bunch of other things are in there, and some interesting things. I recorded again while I was at the antique store in Joplin today. You know, it's kind of scary going in there and saying, do you mind if I record? And first the woman said yes, and she said, hold on, let me ask my boss. And I thought, oh my gosh. And she said, sure. So I recorded, and people were passing by, and I'm trying to talk and record. I was a little self-conscious about it, but then after a while, I thought, it became easier with practice. So now, I'm going to see if I can edit this video, put all the little pieces together, and kind of share with you some of the interesting things I saw today. I don't know how long it's going to take, but I'm hoping I can get it done in the next couple of days. So, until later.